In this lesson, we are going to scaffold a show screen and an edit screen, and again compare the end result with what we have done in previous lessons. Okay, so to scaffold a show screen, I'm going to repeat the steps that I did for the list screen. So I'm going to drag the entity supplier into the webflow. And again, as you can see by the visual hint, this will create the supplier show screen. So dragging the entity into the webflow creates a screen to show a record, and it connects this screen to the list screen. And again, a bunch of stars appeared, so a lot of work was done for us. Let's see what was done in our application. And the first thing we'll do is to open the supplier list, and you'll notice that there's a new link here on the name column. And this link goes to the supplier show screen. And now, remember, for the show screen, we need to have an input parameter. Here it is, of data type supplier identifier. This input parameter is used in the query that we'll have on the preparation. And again, here the preparation. So the query that uses the input parameter that gets the supplier. Here it is. And then this query, the result of this query, let's go into the screen now. Here we have our screen with the title and with the show record. And this show record is bound to the query on the preparation. Okay, so this is the show screen. Now let's repeat the same steps that we did for the list and the show screen to create the edit screen. So again, drag and drop the supplier entity into the webflow. The third time you drag the entity into the webflow, it creates a screen to edit or create a record and connects it to the show and list screens. These screens include all the functionality we've implemented step by step in the previous lessons. And again, let's start this review from the supplier list. And now you'll notice that we have a new action here to create a new supplier. This link goes into the supplier edit, and as you would expect, the supplier edit screen includes an input parameter that is not mandatory for the create action. It includes a query in the preparation that uses this input parameter, and this query, the result of this query, is bound to the edit record on the screen. So here on the edit record. And again, we have the title depending on if it is creating a new supplier or if it's editing an existing supplier. And finally, we have a save action here. And this save action pretty much does what you would expect. It validates the inputs. And if they are not valid, it renders back the edit record for you to fix the data that is not correct. And if it is valid, it creates or updates the supplier and redirects the user back to the supplier list. The final thing we need to show you is where this link from the supplier show to the supplier edit is created. And if we go into the supplier show, you'll notice that now we also have an action here to edit this supplier. So let's test all this in our application. Okay, so here we have our supplier's application. We have an action to create a new supplier. We have the show. So let's go into one of these suppliers, the Abbott Laboratories, and we have the show screen here with all the data. We can edit the supplier, and let's say that we want to change something here. So let me just say that I want to remove here this parenthesis from this phone number and save it. And there you have it, a fully functional show and edit screen in your application. And that's it.